Amen. Ain't the Lord good to us tonight? Ain't the Lord good to us tonight? Ain't he been good to you today? Blessed us beyond all measure. God's grace has been sufficient. Had some good old timey skin in the hide last night. And I appreciate Brother Brandon. And looking forward to hearing Jacob tonight preach. And we just want the Lord to have his will and way in the service tonight. Oh, I'd like to get connected up tonight. Wouldn't you? Amen. I really would. I'd like to get a hold of that fire from that other world and let the Lord just shine his light down in our hearts. And the Bible said we've not been born of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible seed. And when the Lord come into our life, he give us something that's real. And if you're here tonight and you ain't got something real, the Lord give you something that's real. Something, amen, besides religion. And religion, it'll make you miserable. But salvation will give you joy. Joy. So good to see everybody tonight. We want you just to find your place now in the house of the Lord. And everybody just get right in the service. And we're going to sanctify ourselves tonight. And I heard my wife telling somebody today over the phone. I don't know who she was talking to. But she said that we just keep a believing in the word. She said, Jason, every night tells everybody. When I was praying, when all this COVID first started, let me just tell all y'all this. I was reading in the book, in the Word of God, where the Bible said the kings went out in the battle. There was five nations that had come against them. And the scripture said that they sent out the singers to sing. And the Bible said that they sung this song, "The Lord is good and his mercy endureth forever." They didn't have a sword in their hand. And I thought, well, if that's good enough for them, that'll be good enough for us. And so our faith is in the word of the Lord. And we've had folks that's come to church that's had the COVID. And nobody in the church caught it from them. Amen. Y'all look at me and smile at me now. Praise the Lord. Amen. Now, I believe in it, don't you? I sure believe in the Lord's word more than I do in that sanitizer. Well, sure I do. I believe in the power of the word of the Lord. We ain't no better than nobody else. But we're asking the Lord to help us. And we're pleading the word of God over us each night. So let's all stand and let's do it together tonight. Let's say it just like we mean it. And we're going to pray the Lord just protect us. Get all that out of our mind where we can have a good time in the Lord. The Lord is good and his mercy endure forever. The Lord is good and his mercy endure forever. The Lord is good and his mercy endure forever. All the young people come sing tonight. Praise the Lord. All of our young people, man, come a running. Come a-running tonight. Praise the Lord. Want everybody to feel welcome tonight to come and sing and be a part of the service. Let's sing, sing, sing. Sing unto the Lord.
Thank you.
that while they sang it. Every one of them lambs that was slain didn't do none of them people no good. Because they entered not into Canaan because of unbelief. Now it did two of them good. Old Caleb, he had it on his door, and they got spared. And Joshua had it on his door. But all them other thousands, they saw God. They eat the manna in the wilderness. They watched the waters part. They seen all the miracles that God had done. That blood was shed, and the Passover, they passed over death. But when it come time to enter in, the Bible said they could not enter in because of unbelief. Now, all of us that's been saved, that blood's been shed for us as well. But not the blood of the Lamb like it was that night in Egypt. It's the blood of the Lamb of God. Now, all of us, now we ain't made it in yet either. You know what's going to keep us from getting in? Unbelief. That's why people don't fear God. If they feared the Lord, they'd believe in God. You can't fear something you don't believe in. Ain't that the truth? So let's fear the Lord tonight. Let's fear Him tonight. And thank God we can make it. I just want to say I believe. I believe in the death. I believe in the burial. And I believe on Easter Sunday morning. Amen. As it come the first day of the week. I believe that Mary Magdalene and several other of the women came down to the tomb and they talked to one another, and the Bible got in on their talk, and here's what it said. How shall we roll the stone away? How shall we roll the stone away? And they got up yonder and the Bible said there was two men sitting on the tomb, on the stone, and said, why seek ye the living among the dead? Thank God He's alive tonight, church. We don't serve a dead God. We serve a God tonight that's alive. He's alive forevermore. And I bless His name tonight. And I appreciate Him tonight. I come tonight to get something from the Lord. How about you tonight? He's alive tonight. You pray for Him tonight. Everybody mind the Lord tonight. Mind the Lord.
There is a river whose streams may glad the city.
Everybody help me sing this old song. As the world looks upon me, as I struggle along, they say I have nothing, but they are so wrong. In my heart I'm rejoicing, how I wish they could see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. I've a roof up above me. I've a good place to sleep. There's food on my table and shoes on my feet. You gave me your love, Lord, and a fine family. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. Let me sing a second verse. Now you know we're not wealthy, and our clothes, they're not new. We don't have much money, but Jesus, we have you. And to me, that's all that matters, though the world may not see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. I've a roof up above me. I've a good place to sleep. There's food on my table, and there's shoes on my feet. You gave me your love, Lord, and a fine family. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. Has he been good to you tonight? Oh, he has. He's been good to us. Praise the Lord. Testified you.
I thank the Lord for saving me and his many blessings of life. I thank him most of all for saving me, giving me a home and neighborhood. His life is over. I love him. I thank him for touching me.
Yeah, praise the Lord.
I thank him for saving Alan.
Yeah, amen. Amen.
As I wake up with the morning of each day that passes by, and I listen to the sound upon my ear, I can't help but think of what the Lord is to the sky, and I wonder if the trumpet
got this thing organized.
Love.
then we're going to let the preacher come. I tell you what I'd love to see tonight. I want to tell you what I yearn to see in my soul with all of my heart. I don't know, how many of you had a good Christmas with your family? You had a good Christmas with your family? Everybody have that? I mean, we did. We had. I'm going to tell you something, Brother Walter. Something greater than every bit of the fellowship that you had at the table while you was eating, and all the presents and all of that that you sharing with your children, your grandchildren. I want to tell all of you something that would beat that all to pieces. If you and your family could get together in this altar after a while and hold each other's hands and let the God of heaven come down upon you and your family together, wouldn't that be something? Oh, that would be so out of this world. For a mom and a dad, amen, children holding their children's hands and getting on this altar just like you would at the supper table when they call for Christmas dinner and they call for that. Everybody gather in and, you know, you say the blessing and all like that. But when's the last time that you've got on the altar? Look up here at me. Amen. When's the last time that you got on the altar with your children, your wife and your husband, hold hands with one another, and let the holy power of God just shine down upon your life? That would beat every bit of Christmas. That would beat everything that you got under a tree. That would beat, I don't know what Jacob's going to preach on tonight, but I don't have to, I don't worry. He can preach to the sinner. He can preach to the saint. But I tell you one thing, we can have this every night if we desire this. I do. I desire that. I'd love to, amen, get on the altar and, amen, have my daughter Hannah shouting on one side of me, have Julie shouting on the other side, and hear my wife shouting, and see both of my boys down there praying, and, amen, watching Addison just pat Christy while she says, hey, that means everything. That's more than anything in this world. Now, if you want it, you can have it. Oh, it'll embarrass my children. Amen. Don't we? A lot of us has waited too late. A lot of us has waited too late. You know the church don't know how to pray no more. I ain't talking about coming down here by yourself like Brandon and some of the men do. I'm talking about during church service. Amen. We've got a right tonight to go get our family and come down here and just wait on the Lord. Well, if the Lord don't bless you tonight, go get them tomorrow night. And show God that you're hungry. Show God that you're desiring to have His light shine upon your family. That you want the light of God to shine down upon you tonight. There won't be nothing no better. Oh, you'll love your wife like you ain't never loved her. You'll love your husband. Your children will think more of you, mama. They'll think more of you, daddy, than all the presents. And I ain't trying to kill service. I'm just telling you tonight, if we can get a hold of the Lord tonight on this altar together, hallelujah, praying and seeking the power of God together, we seeking God's will, trying to help each other when we're weak, trying to help each other when we're downtrodden, there's a God tonight that can lift us up together tonight. Amen. Praise the Lord. You pray for me. Amen. Then we're going to let the preacher come. That's what I want tonight for Christmas.
I am free because you said I am free. I am free no matter how I feel, no matter what I see. Your word is my authority in every season of life. So as for me and my house, we're gonna be
free. As for me and my head. about the name of Jesus before you sit down?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Amen.
I ask you to sing it all the time, I know, but there ain't nothing better to sing about.
Why, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
There are days when I feel the enemy surrounding me. If I breathe, he will come and devour me. All I gotta do is speak his name. Oh, just speak his name. There are days when I feel the enemy surrounding me. If I breathe, he will come and devour me. All I gotta do is speak his name. Oh, just speak his name. Jesus, there's something about the name of Jesus. Healing in the name of Jesus. There's peace in the name of Jesus. Jesus, there's something about the name of Jesus. Healing in the name of Jesus. Peace in the name of Jesus. He made the lame to walk. He caused the dumb to talk. He made the blind to see. And he made a way for me when I was down and out, deep in despair. My Savior came and he met me there. He brought me out. Yeah, he brought me out. There were days when I feel the enemy surrounding me. And if I breathe, he will come and devour me. But all I gotta do is speak his name. Oh, just speak his name. Jesus, there's something about the name of Jesus. There's healing in the name of Jesus. Peace in the name of Jesus. Jesus, there's something about the name of Jesus. There's healing in the name of Jesus. Peace in the name of Jesus. Jesus.
Amen. Amen. All right. I appreciate it. Had wonderful singing tonight. Brother Timothy will be preaching for us tomorrow night, and Brother Jacob will be preaching for us on this coming Saturday night. And I was thinking while they was singing, everybody but Jacob of our preachers is married and got children. And Brandon, of course, got two daughters, and Timothy's got a little baby girl, and Jacob, he's got a little baby boy, a little baby girl. And they're going to go in church. They're going to raise their children in church just like I did. And they're going to go through all the motions of being raised in church. They're going to see all of it. But until you see the Spirit of God upon your children, I'm not talking about going through the motions like ducks going down to the water. I'm talking about when the Spirit of the Lord, it's genuine. When you know that God himself has touched them. I mean, they can go to every camp meeting and follow you all over the country. But when you get that, when you feel that, you'll be like old Simeon when he held up Jesus and say, Lord, I'm now ready. I don't want to die yet because I ain't seen the Lord on all of my children. But when I finally see that, Brother Brandon, when I see the Lord, you'll know what I'm talking about. You'll want to see it so bad on Addison, you'd do anything. You'd crawl to Grundin back if that's what it took. But you can't make it happen like that. If you could, I'd have tried it. I'd been trying it. You can't do it. All you got to do is just wait for the wind to blow. And sooner or later, them little old youngins that don't ever pay attention and just looking, just waiting for the good night, and God bless you. Oh, boy, that wind will touch their spirit. Boy, when that happens, then I'll be ready to leave here. Because I'll know, amen, that God himself has touched them. Well, I appreciate Jacob so much. I thank the Lord for him. And he kindly grew up in this church and went to school here. And Antioch, we've watched him. We've watched his mommy beat him half to death. And amen, and all like that. And I sure am proud of him and the man of God that he's become. I'm proud of him, and he's becoming a great preacher. And we're so tickled to have him. But before he comes, I'd like to pray for him. I'd like for all of us just to bow our heads. And let's ask God tonight to anoint this young man and give him fire in his belly. Amen. To be able to preach the gospel. Lord, in Jesus' name, we thank you tonight, Lord, for this day. And thank you, God, for this young man. God, his first night in revival, Lord. I pray tonight, Lord, that you'd let 1,000 blessings of heaven fall down on his soul tonight, Lord, that you'd anoint him and give him power, God, to preach this gospel. Oh, tonight, Lord, that he may send out the gospel call to each one of us tonight, Lord, and challenge our hearts as Brandon did last night. We pray, God, in Jesus' name now, Lord, if there's one lost, that you'd help them. Just give his mind clear thinking and just let the word of God flow through him like a river. And God, we'll thank you for it in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Amen. All right, let's give the man of God a hand as he comes to preach.
Amen. If you have your Bibles, turn to Matthew chapter 11. Before I get started, I want to say a special thank you to Brother Jason. You know, a lot of pastors have closed down over fear and other things, and we've closed down for 2 weeks that I know of because of the sickness got out of hand. But I'm thankful for a pastor who will have revival in the midst of a pandemic, aren't y'all? I'm thankful, aren't y'all? I'm happy that we have someone that we can come to church, and I appreciate you for that, Jason. And that's all the sappy stuff I got. And Matthew chapter 11, I'm going to start reading in verse number 21, if the Lord would help me. And I was reading on this the other day, and the Lord gave me this thought a few days ago. And verse number 21, it says, "Woe unto thee, Chorazin, Bethsaida, I don't know that word, but I'll get to it in a minute. If the mighty works which were done in you had been done in Tyre and Sidon, they would have repented long ago in sackcloth and ashes. But I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon at the day of judgment than for you. And thou, Capernaum, which art exalted unto heaven, shall be brought down to hell. For if the mighty works which have been done in thee had been done in Sodom, it would have remained until this day. But I say unto you that it shall be more tolerable for the hand of Sodom in that day of judgment than for thee. At that time Jesus answered and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good to in thy sight. All things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father. Neither any man knoweth the Father save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. Come unto me, all ye that are heavy, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. Yeah. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. And that's all I'd like to read. And I know it was a lot to read, and I struggle to read, but that's not the point. The last three verses is what I want to focus on. And if the Lord would help me, I want to preach on, are you tired of being tired? Are you tired of sin? Are you tired of being tired? And I got to thinking a few days ago about how I was sick and I was going through things, and I slept for pretty much all day, and I came downstairs and I got to thinking, I'm so sleepy, but I'm tired of being tired. I'm tired of laying in my bed. I'm tired of laying there and feeling nothing. I wanted to go downstairs. I was sick as a dog and didn't want to get up, but I was tired of being tired. And I got to thinking about the lame man laying by the pool of Bethesda for 38 years. It said he had an infirmity, and he was tired of being tired, and he laid there, and year after year and day after day he walked by, and he was saying, an angel's going to come and stir the water, and I'm going to be able to get in, and I'm going to be able to be made whole. But it wasn't until Jesus came by and said, be thou made whole, and he made whole, and he didn't even need the pool. And I got to thinking about how when we get tired and we're laying by the pool wanting God, but he'll come by and he'll give us something that we can move on. And I got to think, I was preaching last night, and I was talking about the water of life, and I was preaching about the woman who came to Jacob's well, and Jesus met her, and he said, I'll give you a living water that it may flow freely as a fountain out of you. And I got to thinking about how some people don't have that living water. No doubt in my mind, that lady was lost and undone without God. She had had five husbands before, and she was with someone that wasn't even her husband. But I got to thinking about how we're lost and undone without God, and we're tired, but we're not tired enough. We're not tired of being tired. And I got to thinking about when I was reading this today, and it said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and take my yoke upon thee. And it says, you'll find rest unto your souls. And I get to thinking about, we don't take God on us. We decide that we're going to try to do it ourselves. We decide that we're going to try to make it work. We're going to try to do this. But I was thinking about a car, and you can't put a Ford motor into a Chevrolet. You can't put a Dodge motor into a Ford, and you can't, so forth and so on. It's got to fit right. And we can't put things of the world into us, because it's not going to fit right. We got to have Jesus in our life and Jesus in our soul. But we got to get to the point to where we're tired of being tired. And I got to thinking about the man who was so tired of being tired that he was laying on his bed, and he said, boys, I believe if we go to the man of God in the house that he can heal me. And he was waiting, and they get there and they see that there's no room to enter in. He said, boys, he said, I'm so tired of being tired. I just want y'all to help me. And they tore off the roof and they get up there, and no doubt it was hard. It's a grown man, and no doubt that they were tired, but he was more tired of being tired. He was tired of laying in the bed and not having any help and not having any desire to do anything, because he was so down and out. But when he got down out of that roof, and the Lord said, rise up, take that bed and walk, it said he ran. And I want to see somebody come to the altar and that's lame and that can't walk and that's tired of being tired, and run out of the door and shouting and praising God for saving their soul. And I think about the man the man that was standing at the gate. He said, help. He was screaming help. And Peter and John came up to him and said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have give I thee, in the name of Jesus Christ. And it didn't say in the name of Buddha, in the name of Allah, it didn't say in the name of Muhammad, it said in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And I get to thinking about the woman who had the issue of blood, and she was, I think it was 12 years that she was ill, and all she had to do was go to Jesus, and she had to get to him, but she had to go through something first. And that's what we do on the altar. We want to get to Jesus. We're tired of being tired, but we have to crawl through the crowd. We have to press through and make our way, and we have to find out for ourselves how hard it is to get rid of that load that we put on ourselves for years and years. And I remember in my life a few years ago, I was thinking, and the Lord was dealing with me, and I didn't live right for the Lord at the time, and I was thinking, I'm so tired of waking up every day and doing the same old thing of living in sin, trying to hide from my parents, trying to hide from this, hide from that, play church, and when I would come to church, everything would be okay, and then I'll go back out the next day and be doing the same thing over again. And I got so tired of being tired. I got so sick and tired of things being the same and things being not. I wasn't happy. A personality was not mine. I've always been a happy-go-lucky type of person, and I was so sick and tired of being tired. And I get to thinking about all these things in the Bible. People are tired of being tired, but if you're not tired of being tired, I'm scared for you. I really am, because we're living in the last days, no doubt. We just elected a man in office. I'm not ashamed to say I don't really care much for him personally, but he's still our leader. Nevertheless, we got to pray for him. But I'm so tired of our country not being tired. I'm tired of going in revival and it being dead. I'm tired of things happening that we just don't care about. I'm tired of people asking us to pray. We say a 5-second prayer, Lord help them, Lord heal them, and we're done. I'm tired of just the same old thing, as that song says, a religion, and I'm tired of the things, and I want the Lord to rain down, but first we got to get so tired of being tired. And I was reading this verse. And it says, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. You think you're carrying a burden now, and you're in sin, and you're carrying a burden. It's a heavy burden. I know what it's like. I've been there, the drugs, the alcohol, anything that may be going on in your life. You know sin. I mean, most people in here, pretty much everybody in the world knows what sin is. I mean, everybody does. You know, if you're doing wrong, this thing that he's planted in you called a conscience, amen, it can be seared, and that's the problem. I get worried about people being turned over and getting their conscience seared. My mom always told me, through all the whippings like Jason was talking about, which I thank her for, but she always told me, she said, listen to the little voice, she said, because someday you might push it away so much that it won't even be there anymore. And listen to that voice tonight. I know somebody's in here lost, or I wouldn't have this message on my heart. But if you listen to that voice pricking your heart, no matter where you may be, no matter what you may be going through, and you come down to the altar, people will pray with you, and you can sup with him and him with you. It says in Revelation chapter 22, it says, behold, I come quickly. He's coming whether you want him to or not. He's coming. If you're living right or if you're not, he's coming. In the dead of the night, he's coming as a thief in the night. And if you're not ready to meet him, then you're going to be so tired. Amen. I think about the rich man in hell, and he was so tired. And he gets in hell. He said, if I could just get a drop of water on my tongue. He said he was so tired in hell. And I don't want anyone here to go to hell. And the odds are stacked against us, but on everything else, aren't the odds stacked against us on everything else? We can defy the odds, and we can go against the grain, and we can go and live a life of holiness and live a life of truth. But we got to get to the point to where we're tired of being tired. And we got to get to the situation to where we're sick of our sin. We're sick of laying in the same filth. The prodigal son, he went out, and he went out with all of his friends and partied, I would assume, and went out and spent all he had, and they found him laying with the hogs. And maybe that's where you're at tonight. I don't know. Maybe spiritually you're laying with the hogs and you're just so tired of being tired. But I got something to tell you. You can come home and the Father will give you a ring. He'll give you the precious garments. He'll make you a meal to where you can dine with him forevermore. And he'll give you the bread of life and the water that flows freely. He'll give you a zeal and a desire to live for him. He'll give you a desire to read the Bible, to pray, to want to get your lost people in. And he'll give you a desire to seek his face, and he'll give you a desire to hunger and thirst after righteousness. And you know what the end of that verse is? Those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, they shall be filled. And if you hunger and thirst after righteousness, you shall be filled. If you hunger and thirst after the filth of the world, if you hunger and thirst after alcohol, or you hunger and thirst after drugs and things like that, then you're just feeding the world. But it never said you shall be filled with that stuff. It says they who hunger and thirst after righteousness, they shall be filled. But it says, come unto me, all ye that are laboring and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Amen. You're so tired of being tired, he'll give you rest when you're tired. Amen. And it says, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest in your souls. There's another verse talking about rest. He'll give you rest. He'll give you a pillow to lay your head on at night when your body aches with pain and you're sick and you're out of it. And it'll give you a thing that you can have with you. And when you're sick and when you're out and when you're all alone, but you're never alone. A woman was testifying last night. She said, "You feel like you're all alone, but he's just making you stronger, or he's helping you to avoid you from something else." But the last verse says, "For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." His burden is lighter. I mean, I've been preaching for 6 months, and this burden has been heavy, but it's also been light. I think about the burden I had when I was lost in sin, and it was so heavy, and there was no reward to it. There was no satisfaction. After I got done, the burden was still there, but there was nothing to ease the pain. He'll give you something if you take of his yoke and you learn of him, then he'll give you something, and his burden will be light. He'll be there to help you carry it when it gets too heavy. He'll be there to help you carry it, like the man when he helped Jesus carry the cross. Jesus was going up the hill, and his name was Simon, and he got up there, and he helped him carry the cross, and he gave his life willingly so that you and I could be set free. If Sarah would come to the piano, amen. I want to give an altar call to someone in here tired of being tired. Are you sick of the same old thing? Are you sick of living in sin? You see the people that are saved and you want to be like them. Why don't you? Why don't you be like them? There's nothing that's holding you back besides pride. And the devil's holding you back with sin and things like that. If you're tired of being tired tonight, you can come to this altar and find rest for your weary soul. And you can come unto me, or come unto God. It says, "All ye that labor and are heavy laden." Are you heavy? Are you heavy in heart tonight? Are you lost and undone without God? As she begins to play, whenever she's ready. Amen. I want to heed to the lost people and give an invitation. Amen. Because it's serious. It's too serious to let it go by. It's too serious to walk out of here without knowing that you're ready to go. Because you could be in a car accident. The weather might get bad. You never know. And you could go out into eternity and all you'll hear is, "I was tired of being tired and I never found rest." Amen. You can come up tonight right now. Grab somebody by the hand. Take them and say, "I want to go pray and make things right before it's too late." If anybody would like to come pray. Amen. I want to extend the invitation. I want to keep going because I feel like there's somebody in here who's tired of being tired. Amen. Who's ready for a change in their life. Amen. If there would be anybody. Amen. Don't let pride get in the way of eternity. Amen. Don't let pride get in the way of the best thing you'll ever find. Amen. 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 With every head bowed and every eye closed. Amen. Nobody's looking around. Nobody's peeking. Amen. It's just between me, you, and God. If anybody in here is lost and you're tired of being tired, would you please just lift up your hand? I'll pray for you. I won't come to you. I won't embarrass you. I just want to see if there's anybody in here. I know there is. I don't know where you're at. I might could decipher it, but I don't want to. I want God to draw you. Amen. If there's anybody in here, if you're tired of being tired, the tears running down your cheek, those aren't fake. That's conviction. The thing in your stomach that's churning, wanting you to get up and go to the altar, that's conviction. If there would be anybody, amen, that would just lift up your hand just for another second. Amen. Oh, God. Amen. You can lift up your head. Amen. If you know someone in here, I would advise you to talk to them. I would. I mean, it's in dire need of going to this, because this is such a situation. It's nothing to be messed with. Amen. I wasn't trusted with matches when I was younger, and I look back and realize that one strike of a match can burn down everything. The fire just gets bigger and bigger, and that's how sin gets. You get one strike of a match, and it just gets bigger and bigger and bigger until you can't control it anymore. But amen, there's a phrase called fighting fire with fire. I got a fire, amen, that shut up in my bones that God has given me to fight the fire of the devil. Amen, and you can come get it tonight. You just got to humble yourself. That's all you got to do. That's all you got to do. All you got to do is come to him. Amen. Come, all ye that are laboring and are heavy laden. Amen. And he'll give you rest. Amen. That's all I have. I'm going to turn it over to Brother Jason. Amen. If you need to pray, I would advise you to come pray. Amen.
God bless you, preacher. God bless you, preacher. Did you enjoy that? Amen. That's wonderful. Let's give him a hand. Amen. Sarah, can you sing us a verse of that song, "If I Could Just Touch"? Thought about that while he's preaching. Now, the King of all kings, the Lord of all lords. That's who he's preaching about. He's saying, come unto me. And no matter what your need is, no matter what your troubles are, I can just hear him say, come to me. When you hear them words in that way that is used in a sentence, it's almost like the man that's saying that's got the answer. Come to me. You've tried all this? Come to me. Come to me. I just wonder right now, he's been waiting on us. Is there any moms? Is there any dads? Any husbands, any wives? Like to go and get their family. And gather around these altars. Talk to God. Seek the face of the Lord together. Pray together. Hold hands with each other. Look up unto our God, our King, and our Lord, and ask God's favor. Save our people. Save our people. Is there anybody right now who wants to do that?